They say that an NHL playoff team can go as far as their goaltender will take them. But are GMs overpaying for goaltenders that have a track record of being a top-notch guy?
Here at the Tippy College of Business, one economics teacher is mixing econ with goaltending?
UI professor of economics Stacy Brook conducted a study that GMs should look at to evaluate goalie talent.
We looked at how they evaluate or how they pay for different types of things that goalies do.
Brooks's formula on how to judge goalie performance is based off of save percentage divided by the number of points their team has in the standings. By using this formula, average goalies and Hall of Famers are not that far apart. What led Brook to use this formula is the fact that goalies in the NHL are the most inconsistent position. It is hard to base their future performance on wins alone because the team changes year in and year out.
They have different teammates, they have different defensemen, and they tend to have different impacts as to the number of shots that the goalie faced, the type of shot that they face.
In the 2009 season, Buffalo Sabres and U.S. Olympic goalie Ryan Miller was judged as the best goalie using Brooks's formula, and now the Sabres are out of the NHL playoffs early. This goes to show that goaltenders in the NHL are unpredictable, and that save percentage is a more important indicator of performance than wins and losses. Brendan Ferguson, Daily Iowan TV.